The next aspect that we would understand is per capita GDP. What is per capita GDP? Per capita means per person. As simple as that. So per capita GDP is nothing. It is GDP divided by the total population. Now, understand a very important concept. I compared two regions. One is Japan. The other is Montana state of United States. Now, Japan has a population which is nearly 128 times Montana in terms of population. In terms of production, it is nearly 145 times the production in Montana. But still, both have the same per capita GDP. Let's understand how. Japan has a production of $5.4 trillion divided by its 126.5 million population. So, what is the GDP generated? GDP generated is $42,700. Montana has a population, has a GDP of $46.2 billion. Understand the difference here. It is just billion in Montana. In Japan, it was trillion. The population in Montana is very less, 1.1 million. So, the GDP generated is around, again, $42,000. So, we understand the GDP for both the regions are same. Both the regions enjoy the same standards of living. But despite the fact that the population of Japan is 128 times and the GDP generated is 145 times, despite of that, both of them have the same per capita GDP. Now, before we proceed on to the limitations of GDP, let's understand a very important concept. If I talk about GDP in general, what is GDP? I summarize again, it is the dollar value of the production within the nation's boundary. So what would be impacted if what factors are impacted, it would impact the GDP. If my prices are increasing, then GDP would increase, definitely, because it is price into the quantity produced. So you have increase in the price that would affect the GDP. Then let's say if I have increase in the population, with increase in the population, I would have more consumption. So more expenditure, and therefore GDP would increase. So GDP, understand this concept, extremely important. Understand this concept carefully. GDP would increase with increase in price, increase in population. What about real GDP? Real GDP would increase with only increase in population because it is inflation adjusted. It won't change with price change. Price, let it keep changing. I have already kept the price based on the base year. So my base year was $5. Let's say my base year price was $5. So the price is already the same. So real GDP would be affected by increase in population, but would not be affected by increase in prices. Extremely important. Now, what does per capita GDP depend on? Per capita GDP would depend on increase in GDP, but it would not depend on population increase. Why? Because it is per capita. I am dividing the GDP by the population. So we need to understand which of the GDP would be affected by what factors. If I talk about nominal GDP, again it would be affected by price rise as well as population increase. So GDP is a estimate which is very, very important to understand. When we talk about GDP, we are actually ignoring or underestimating numerous factors which happen in the economy. What are those factors? The underground economy. So it would include any kind of illegal activities in the economy, payments under cash, any household vegetable garden production that I am doing, any household car repair that I am doing. So all those would not be counted in the GDP of the nation. So therefore, underground economy is not counted in the GDP, and that's one of the major limitations of GDP.